Adding really cool finishing touches to your Indomitus miniatures is a wonderful way of bringing them to life on the battlefield. In this video, Peachy and I can look at different finishing touches for both Space Marines and Necrons. We'll look at adding scripture onto parchment, adding transfers onto Space Marine shoulder pads, and then we'll look at adding an eerie green glow to Necron miniatures. So grab your paintbrushes and let's get started. So first of all, let's have a look at painting the scripture onto the parchment of Space Marines. We'll look at two different things here. First of all, that really tiny scripture you see painted onto purity seals, and then also we'll look at the larger scripture painted onto things like scrolls. First of all, that tiny script that goes onto purity seals. And for this, rather than actually writing real letters, which would be far too small at that scale, we're going to get the impression of words, and here's how we're going to do it. Let's imagine this is a purity seal on a Space Marine, such as this Space Marine captain here. We're going to take some thin down black paint, and rather than writing real letters, we're going to add squiggly lines onto our purity seal like so, across the top like this, adding breaks here and there to give the impression of words. At this scale, that'll look just like actual writing. So let's have a look at this on a miniature. So what we're going to do here is take some Abaddon black paint, thin it down with a touch of water, and then using our small airbrush, add it to our model to make it look like writing. Let's grab some paint from the pot like so, and onto our palette here. Now what we're going to do here is add a bit of water, but not too much. We're just thinning it down to make sure it goes on nice and smooth. We're not trying to make a wash or anything like that at all. We're also being really light touching with the brush to make sure it keeps its natural point. And we're going to just rifle it back on our palette like so to make sure it's got the smallest amount of paint on and that it's nice and pointy. Then onto our Space Marine Captain. Here, we're going to add it onto the purity seal on the shield at the front like so. Just touching really lightly, adding very, very small amounts of paint like so. Squiggles onto the purity seal like this. So subtle, so light, and it'll give the nice effect of writing on your purity seal. There we go, that's our purity seal done. Let's try something different as well on the miniature. Here we're going to add larger letters like illuminated manuscripts onto the parchment too by adding different colours. Let's have a look at what I'm talking about. Let's take a different colour here and just add a large letter, let's say for example R at the top. Then we're going to add the writing in as we've done before with the little squiggles like so across the parchment like this. Want to add a U for Ultramarines here. Let's just put that there. And then we'll do the same again, the squiggles across the parchment like so, running down the parchment. Again, let's have a look at this on a miniature. Okay, so to add that fancy lettering onto your parchment. Now you can use just about any of the darker colours in the range, they all work really well on parchment. But here we're going to use corn red. We've got some corn red in our palette already. We're going to add a touch of water just to thin it down to make sure it's really smooth and thin. A little bit more, there we go. Bingo. Also, I'm making sure our brush is super pointy, so good brush control here is important. Just make sure we've got a tiny amount on the very, very tip, and making sure it's just enough to do the big letters with. So there we go, onto our Space Marine Captain. Here we're going to do just the parchment under the tilting shield here. I'm going to add a letter here. Let's go for an R, like so. Just going to very, very carefully draw an R, like so. This does take a bit of control. Hold your breath as you do it. There we go. Let's also add maybe a T down here as well. Then we'll take the Abaddon Black, which we had before, and then very carefully we'll add the other squiggles around the writing to make it look like parchment. There we go, that's the purity seals painted on our Space Marine Captain, all apart from this one at the front, but let's cover that now. So next up, let's have a look at painting larger words onto Space Marine parchment. This might be the name of a Space Marine on his shoulder pad, or perhaps an important word on a banner or a scroll. Let's have a look at how we do this. Let's imagine this is our scroll we're going to paint a word onto. We want to paint the word Ultra for an Ultramarines army, or perhaps Angels for a Dark Angels or Blood Angels army onto it. The first thing we want to do is to find the central letter of the word. Here is easy on Ultra, it's the T. We're going to put number 1 underneath it. If your word has an even number of letters, like Angels, number 1 goes next to the two central letters, here G and E. Then, working out, number the letters away from the central one. So here we're going to number 2 like that, and number 3 here on the outside letters, like this. The reason we do this is the order we're going to paint the letters in to ensure that the name is nice and evenly spaced out on the scroll. Let's have a look then at writing the word Ultra. We'll start with the letter T, as that's a central one. We'll find the center of the scroll and paint the T in the center here. Then the R and the L are equidistant away from it, making sure there's space enough for the outside letters as well. So R and L. Then the A and the U are painted next, ensuring they're nice and evenly spaced out from those letters and also evenly spaced away from the scroll too. That way, your letters are nice and evenly spaced out. You're not trying to rush and trying to get a few letters in at the very end and have them all squeezed in. So let's see how this works on a miniature. So it's back to our pot of Abaddon Black and our small layer brush. Let's take a touch of black from the pot like so and onto our palette here. Now we're being really light with our brush here, we'll make sure we're keeping our point. I'm just going to take a little bit of water from the pot here and just going to mix it in like there as well. At this point, we're going to wash our brush off and just use a bit of tissue paper to make sure we've got a nice point on the brush like so. Here, we're going to take a touch of that paint from our palette. Just make sure we've got a little bit on the brush. Make sure we've got a really fine point there as well. Bingo. And onto our Space Marine miniature. Here, we're very carefully going to apply that first letter. It's going to be the T in the centre. So we find the centre, we draw that T very finely onto our scroll like so. Now, to be careful here, and pretty much paint like you would with a pen. Let's take your time. So now we're going to draw the R like so. We're going to continue across the entire scroll with all the letters. There we go, that's the scroll done and our parchment complete on our Space Marine Captain. All right, up next, let's have a look at applying transfers to Space Marines. Now, sometimes it can be a bit daunting applying transfers to Space Marine shoulder pads, as often they don't sit flat and can cause crinkling in your transfers. Well, let's have a look at a really good way to get around that and to make those transfers sit nice and flat on your Space Marine shoulder pads. First of all, we need to prepare our model, and for this we're going to be using Arncoat Gloss Varnish on the areas the transfers are going to go on. Grab yourself a medium layer brush and let's apply it now. Let's take a bit of Arncoat Gloss Varnish onto our palette here. I'm going to thin it down with a touch of water, not too much, just a little bit. There we go, perfect. Then, onto our miniature. We're going to be applying this gloss varnish onto the areas the transfers are going to go on. So for our Space Marine Assault Intercessor Sergeant here, it's going to be his shoulder pads, either side, both left and right. Apply a nice good layer all over it, and this will help the transfer sit nice and flat on the shoulder pads. There we go, that's the Ardcoat gloss varnish applied onto our Sergeant's shoulder pads. Now up next, have a look at how we're going to prepare our transfers for application onto the model. Here, what we're looking for is to make sure those transfers sit nice and flat on the shoulder pads and there's no crinkling. Here's how we're going to do it. Now here's a representation of how those transfers appear on the transfer sheet. Obviously I have a blue background here, not a clear background, we just wanted to show you how it works. Now what we're going to be doing here is actually adding a few cuts into the transfers before we cut them out of the sheet using a hobby knife. Heads up here, if you're a younger hobbyist, make sure you're getting someone older to help you out with this one. Now what we want to do is add a few cuts in to make sure parts of the transfer overlap on each other. For example, on the Ultima symbol, what we're going to be doing is adding a cut in the transfer at the top here at 12 o'clock, then another cut here at 2 o'clock, another cut here at 10 o'clock. Crucially, we're not going to be letting these cuts meet in the middle. We're not trying to cut part of the transfer away, but what this will do is when it's applied onto the curved shoulder pad, those parts will overlap on themselves, helping that shoulder pad make that transfer sit nice and flat. On the close support symbol, we're going to add a cut here, 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 and here. Again, crucially, not meeting in the middle. We're not trying to cut the transfer apart, just making sure those are overlapping on the shoulder pad. If you have a battle line symbol, one cut at the top in the centre will be all you need. So here we have our Space Marine transfer sheet. The first transfer we're going to cut out is our Sergeant's Ultima symbol here. First of all, we're going to add those three lines we talked about with our knife, very carefully adding a cut at the 2 o'clock position here, the 12 o'clock position, and one at the 10 o'clock over here as well. Crucially, those lines are not meeting in the middle as we're not trying to cut our transfer in half. Then, very carefully, we're going to cut out around the edge of our transfer like so, being very delicate with a knife to make sure we're getting as close to the transfer as we possibly can. We'll do this with this close support symbol as well, and also with squad marking too. We'll cut them all out of the sheet and apply them to a piece of tissue paper. Okay, so now we've cut out all of the transfers from the transfer sheet we need for this model. We've placed them all onto a piece of tissue paper, and now with a brush, we're going to take our water from our water pot and totally soak the transfers like this. This will help separate the transfers from their backing. You need to completely soak them and allow about 30 seconds to a minute for the transfers to be separated. So it's been about a minute and our transfers are ready to apply. So take that brush again, we've soaked it in water, this time it's nice and wet, and we're going to just very carefully separate that transfer from the backing. Then onto our miniature. Here we're going to very carefully place it onto the shoulder pad of our Space Marine Sergeant, just brushing it onto the shoulder pad like so. Perfect. We'll take one brush full of water from our pot and apply it over the top like this to brush it into place. Then with our Citadel texture tool, going to very carefully poke it around until it's in the place we want it to be in, nice and central on the shoulder pad. You can see the shoulder pad transfer is overlapped, so it's sitting nice and flat. We'll allow about 5 minutes for this to fully dry, and once it has, we'll come back onto the next stage. There we go, the water has dried and our transfers are sitting nice and flat on those shoulder pads. But up next, let's make sure they never come off by sealing them in place. Now for this, we're going to do two things. First of all, a layer of Arco gloss varnish over the top of them to really make sure they're sealed in. Then once that's dry, we'll add a layer of limey and medium over the top of this to help matte down that colour to make it look more natural. First of all, that layer of Arco gloss varnish. For this, we're using our medium layer brush. Let's grab some varnish from the pot and onto our palette here. Add a little bit of water just to thin it down a touch, but not too much. It doesn't really matter how thick this is going to go on, as it's going to dry nice and clear. Then onto our marine. Here, just a nice layer of gloss varnish over the top of the transfer. Apply across the whole area, not just over the transfer. There we go, bingo. Once that's dry, apply a layer of limey and medium by itself over the top to matte the whole area back down again. And there we go, that's the limey and medium dried on the shoulder pads and our transfers are sealed in place. Now you could absolutely leave the transfers there if you'd like to and they would look factory fresh and new. Alternatively, why not try this extra cheeky tip to add a little bit of weathering onto your transfers to make them look beaten and worn. We're going to add chips into the transfers by using the original base coat paint of the miniature. In this case, being an ultramarine, that's Macrag Blue. For this we'll be using our small layer brush. Let's take a bit of paint from the pot and onto our palette here. Now we're going to add the tiniest amount of water, not too much, just a touch, just to help thin that paint down. We're making sure we've got a really fine point on the brush as well. Then, onto our space marine. Here, we're very, very carefully adding tiny, tiny chips into the transfer, just touching it with the blue paint here like so, just to make it look a little bit chipped and beaten. We're basically helping to break up those straight lines all over the transfer. Now, if you put chips in a certain direction, for example, coming from the front to the back like this, it'll look like gunshots have been ricocheting off the Space Marine's armour. And there we go, with the chips applied, our transfers are looking beaten and weathered. And there we go, that's a couple of finishing touches to add to your Indomitus Space Marines. Now it's over to Peachy for a really cool tip for Necrons.
Thank you for that, Nick. So in this tip, we're going to be concentrating on making an eerie glow for our Necron Canoptech Reanimator. So for this, we're going to mainly be concentrating on using dry brushes. However, in some places, we might need to just do some layering up where it's more fine detail, hard to reach areas. So the colours we're going to be using, we're going to start with Caliban Green as our first highlight. Then after that, we'll move to Warpstone Glow, just some of those raised areas, and then finish off with a little bit of Moot Green here and there. But first of all, let's start with Caliban Green. So I've got my small dry brush for this. So I'm just going to load the brush up a little bit and just start rubbing that off on the palette like so. Now obviously you want to make sure you remove as much of the pigment as you possibly can, but just leave little traces left on there. So if I just gently rub there, I can still see there's some green on that. So once that's done, I'm then ready to start applying that to this little area around here. So you obviously got these glowy orbs and stuff. So what we're trying to do is mimic some of that light glowing off them. Now I know there's some highlights here, but that's actually really good because they're going to actually make some of these seem a lot lighter than what they would have been. So all we're going to do is just work our way around, find any of these areas where the glow would probably be seen or reflect from. So I'm just going to work my way around like that. See, it's just changing the tone here and there. Now in some of the deeper areas here, I'm just going to get my layer brush like so, just apply a little bit of water to that because I don't want it too thick and goopy, maybe a little bit more water. And then just go into some of those harder to reach areas and just layer a little bit of Caliban Green. Take your time and do that all the way around these areas here, around here, and then on the opposite side as well. So with the Caliban Green done, we're now going to move on to doing a light, subtle dry brush of Warpstone Glow. Again, you're just trying to tickle some of the edges here to just show some of that lighter green showing through. Just take your time. And again, we might need to move on to using the medium layer brush for some of the more awkward bits just down here. Again, just take your time. We're going to finish off by using Moot Green as a final highlight on some of those raised areas. So all I'm going to do is just gently tickle just around the edges. Like so. And again, I'll probably need to move on to using a little layer brush here and there just for some of those hard to reach zones. But you don't really want too much Moot Green here, it's just really on edges and corners. And there we are with the eerie glow now done. Our finishing touches video is completed. Now remember, by following these techniques and using different colours to match your collection, you can get some really interesting results. Just have a bit of a play to see what interesting combinations you can come up with. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Myself and Nick will see you again soon. Bye-bye.